Assalamualaikum, my dear students of class 9. How are you? Hope all of you are healthy and hearty by the blessing of Almighty Allah. Welcome to our online platform NIVS Home School. This is Mohammad Abul Kalam, assistant teacher of National Ideal English Version School. Dear learners, today I am going to conduct physical studies, physical education and health and science sports class. This class, physical education, health science and sports class. And this is our first class, that means this is the beginning of our class. Dear learners, to see our two topic, let's see. So look, it is topic chapter 1, lesson 1 and 2 reading. And this is our lecture number 1, there is no homework, SW. Dear students, in this connection, I request all of you to open your physical education and health science and sports book, page number 1, okay. Chapter 1, page 1. Physical education for healthy life. This is the title. So let's read. In the past, it was traditionally thought that physical education means physical activities, but it was a wrong concept. Conception: physical activities do not necessarily mean physical education, rather they may be called physical exercise. Issues of physical education not only dealt with physical activities, but they help in attaining mental development. Keep it in your mind, it is mental development and social virtues as well. When your body is not fit, you do not feel mentally well and cannot concentrate on any work. Thus, relationship between body and mind is intertwined. So look here, it is intertwined or closely related, and they cannot be studied separately. The old saying, a sound mind in a sound body, has been regarded as a universal truth in all ages. At present, acquisitions of physical development, mental growth and social skills in physical education. We can get sound life by regular practicing the programs of physical education. A student of physical education will develop a sound mind in a healthy body so that they become a good citizen of the society. Okay, now dear learners, I am telling you to go to your page number 2 to start from lesson 1. It is physical education. Page number 2. To say something about physical education or to define it, first we need to know what education is. Physical education is an integral or inseparable part of the total education process. Without physical education, education remains incomplete. A definition of education will make it easy for us to understand what physical education is. Different scholars have defined educations in different ways, which are related to different situations. Education is not only the intellectual development, it is also includes physical, social and emotional and all-round development of other areas. Education is not limited to a specific point of time in an individual life, but it takes place throughout the life. Education is not only confined to the boundary of school, but it may be acquired from family, society, playground and so on. So look here, a few relevant definitions of education. According to Plato, education helps in the body and soul of the people all the beauty and all the perfection he is capable of. Next, another scholar defined education is the creation of sound in sound mind in a sound body. Next, it is also defined that education is the harmonious development of the body. Harmonious development of the body, mind and soul. According to Charles A. Boozer, physical education is an integral part of the total education process, and its aim is the development of physically, mentally, emotionally and socially fit citizen. Through physical activities which have been selected with a view to realizing their outcomes. From above definition, it is clear that education and physical education are complementary to each other. Next, D.K. Matthews says, physical education is the education which is acquired through physical activities. Now, next please. Hoff, Smith and Clifton says, physical education refers to scientific and systematic movement of limbs. According to J.B. Nash, physical education is the part of the whole field of education that deals with big muscle activities and their related responses that brings changes in an individual's body and personality. From the above definition, it is found that the the essence of physical education, so the key findings of education is all round development of an individual personality. As a result of physical education, one becomes physically fit, mentally sound, emotionally balanced, socially adjusted, morally true, and spiritually uplifted. All these outcomes are achieved by means of recreational activities of games and sports. Now lesson 2. Aims and objectives of physical education. Generally, we do not differentiate between an aims and objectives. In most cases, we often use them interchangeably. But these two terms are not synonymous or not same. There are differences between them. Aim is the first goal, whereas an object is the short and specific steps towards the goal. For example, in case of your climbing the stairs to reach the roof is the aim and every step of the stair is an objective. An aim exists in human imagination which cannot be depicted in really, but an objective is real. Man can achieve the objectives and even it is possible to measure. Physical educationists have mentioned several interim measures to attain the aims. These measures are known as the objectives of physical education. According to Williams, the aim of physical education is all-round development of personality through development of physical, social, and other areas of individual. Book Walters state that the aim of physical education is the optimum or the maximum development of the physically, socially, mentally integrated and adjusted individual. This aim can be achieved through participation in selected sports, rhythmic and their learners. Now we will go to our next phase, phase number 4. It is gymnastic activities conducted according to social and hygienic standard. Though experts have agreed upon some objectives, there are different opinions about some other objectives as well. From the opinions of the majority of experts, we can identify common objectives of physical education. Considering the opinions of various thinkers, the objectives of physical education can be divided into 4 groups. So look, number 1, physical fitness, number 2, mental development, number 3, character development, and number 4 is social adjustment. Number 1 is physical fitness. Top level, maintaining the rules and regulations of games and sports to achieve specific objectives through hard work to improve human capacity through neuromuscular coordination to ensure balanced development of body and mind, to attain physical strength, maintaining good health, and to develop tolerance and self-confidence. Our next point, it is mental development. To develop quick thinking ability, to achieve knowledge about ethics and morality, to be motivated for service and self-sacrifice, to foster friendly and competitive attitude among different teams. Third number point, character development. To develop a sense of obedience and morality, to develop respect for law through games and sports, to develop sportsman-like and friendly attitude, to show respect for opponents, and number to help control emotions and become self-disciplined. Our last number point is social adjustment. Okay, it is page number 5, social adjustment. To acquire leadership qualities, to know constructive ways of passing leisure time, to develop ability to participate in various cultural programs, and to maintain friendly relationship with others, and to participate in welfare activities. Our last segment. From the opinions of physical educationists as mentioned above, it can be said that the objectives of physical education are very similar to that of general education. It also focuses on optimum development or maximum development of personality of individual and on helping them master the art of games and sports through systematic guidance, guidance and participation in sports. Okay. Dear learners, today in lecture number 1, we have finished chapter 1, lesson number 1 and 2. Dear students, from the page number 1 to 5th we have read today, please read the text. These are very easy and very important for our personal life also, not only for cutting a good figure in the exam, but also for gaining a benefit in our personal life. These pages are very important. Please read the text at home. Finally, see you again, inshallah. Assalamu alaikum.